We love it when locals do well. We remember our first guest from Teen Wolf. He's done a bunch of other things. Here comes Tyler Posey. Tyler, you're born in Santa Monica, right?
Hey, I am. I'm a local.
Very good. Where'd you go to high school?
Well, okay, so I was born in Santa Monica, lived there till I was a little baby, and then I moved to Santa Clarita, which you guys mentioned also, and I went to Hart High School.
Look at you. Congratulations. Let me ask you this. Is it sweeter? Because if you grew up in Southern California, obviously the business has always been kind of around, but you didn't, fly in from Oklahoma. You're from here.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, so I don't know. The more and more I got into the business and went to auditions as a young adult, people were like, oh, you're actually from here. That's pretty rare. So it was kind of a discovery for me. But I grew up in Santa Clarita, and that's sort of, on the outskirts of Hollywood. So I kind of, I don't know. I owe my somewhat stable mental health to growing up outside of Hollywood.
All right, speaking of stable mental health, you're very well inked. Is it more than just your arms?
Yes, I've got an eagle on my chest. I've got my stomach. I've got my legs. I started with my legs because I'm an actor, and I wanted to get in places where it couldn't be seen. But I'm also a punk rock dude. I'm in a band, so I don't know.
Okay, I'm going to ask the naive, non-tattooed question. Doesn't it hurt?
Every single time. It hurts worse and worse and worse every single time.
So what makes you go on the table every single time if it hurts every single time?
I've actually grown very fond of the art itself, and I really appreciate the artwork. And I don't even know what I'm going to get when I go to get tattooed. I have a bunch of artists that I really admire their work, and they're kind of respected in the tattoo community. And I get whatever they want to put on me, pretty much, and it's always, good. And I like the work, but I never know what I'm going to get. That's how much I like tattoos.
All right. Last tattoo question. That's none of my business. For your own personal life, do you prefer that special someone is also tattooed or not tattooed?
No preference. No preference at all. I've definitely got some matching tattoos. Why, are you interested?
No. Thanks for asking. But... All right, let's talk about your movie Alone. Now, it's not, art is good when it's topical. This turns out to be super topical. When did you guys make it?
We filmed this over a year ago, so way before COVID was even a thought. There's so many synchronicities within this movie. My character is quarantined for the whole half of the movie, the first half of the movie. He's got a social distance relationship. There's a pandemic going on. If he goes outside, he'll get infected. It looks just like what we're dealing with at home. So it's very timely. Also that it's a little spooky, Halloween's coming up.
Okay, well, we'll get to that in a second. But once the pandemic hit, did you think to yourself, because you obviously had wrapped production, oh my gosh, we've made what's going on, sort of, in a movie.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, there was this huge sort of realization. We were like, whoa, okay, all right, there's going to be some interesting press focused around this movie now that, like, it's basically retelling or telling what we're going through right now. I felt like I was fairly prepared. My character went through some pretty emotional, mental turmoil going through this movie. And I feel like a lot of people have done that, too, because not a lot of people have been alone this long. Their entire lives. And my character has never been alone a day in his life other than the start of this pandemic and in Alone, the movie.
One of your other creative pursuits, a lot of people, and I guess I'm going to say it is notorious, this OnlyFans site. We know it for one specific reason, but what are you contributing to OnlyFans?
So I didn't want to take anything away from the people who really make a living on their doing, sex work and stuff like that. And I love my fans. I love being in touch with them. And I feel like sometimes Instagram doesn't allow me to be as close to them or personal with them as I want. And so I've done a lot of really creative TV shows and episodes that we've created on OnlyFans. And I'm really proud of the stuff that we're doing. It's really, really, really funny. Shows me in a different light, in the light that I want to be seen, and we just have more freedom than other social media avenues to kind of just be really creative and exercise our creative muscle. And that's really what we're doing. It's a lot of fun. And I'm super excited about the content that we're putting out. It's really funny.
All right. So you can find Tyler there. Also, Alone is out on demand, digital, Blu-ray, drop date October 20th. It'll also be available on select streaming platforms. Tyler there. Thanks to him, Frank and Jess across.